Closure of the Canada and U.S. border has been extended for another month. In Edmonton, Bureau Chief Thomas Likeness reports.
Good evening, Anna. Before I get to that story, I just want to take a quick look at our weather, and I know you're in the midst of a heat wave. We've got a heat wave here. I just checked AccuWeather, and you don't have a heat warning. You have an extreme heat warning. It's 112 degrees there. You could fry eggs on the sidewalk. Well, like you said, we have a heat wave here. They're saying high temperatures. Currently, we've got lots of sunshine, 29 degrees Celsius. That's 84 Fahrenheit, quite a ways from that 112. The temperature is supposed to moderate a little bit later in the week. We should be in the mid-20s, which is the high 70s on the Fahrenheit scale. But if I had 112 degrees here, I think I'd be making my breakfast out on the patio there, saving on the power bill. Well, if you're thinking of coming up to Canada for a visit and cooling off, you're going to have to wait a while. As you know, the Canada-U.S. border has been closed to non-essential travel since March 21st, and every month that closure has been extended. And this past week, again, an extension. This time, they'll revisit the idea September 21st. The closure, of course, to prevent the spread of COVID-19. And it's unlikely we'll be putting out the welcome mat before the end of the year, probably sometime next year, because, you know, as long as the number of infections in the U.S. remains high, there's no appetite here to greet visitors. There are a few exceptions, though. Family reunifications, in some circumstances. People who own property in Canada can come up and take care of that. And, of course, those traveling by land to Alaska. But there are quite a few tight restrictions on that, including a time limit for them to get to their destination, and absolutely no sightseeing allowed. A couple of other things I want to mention while I'm here. Our chief public health officer says Canadians will be living with COVID-19 until 2022. Dr. Theresa Tam took a look into her crystal ball. She says the worst case scenario will see a large peak of cases this fall, with more peaks and valleys continuing for 18 months. And that brings up the question, can we handle this new round of infections? Tam warns that the peak this fall could reach higher numbers than ever before and perhaps even overwhelm the healthcare system. And let's hope Murphy's Law doesn't kick. You know Murphy's Law, whatever can go wrong will. Because, you know, as well as COVID-19, Dr. Tam warns that the fall flu season is waiting in the wings. So, you know, public health officials are going to be very, very busy. Just who's being infected these days? Well, it's young people. The latest data in Canada shows a high number of cases in the 20 to 39-year-old demographic. Her takeaway message? Continue to practice the recommended public health measures. You know them. You know them. Hand washing, social distancing, face masks. This is not over. Oh, you recall I told you last week about a harebrained plan in the city of Edmonton after introducing a mandatory face bylaw. Bureaucrats printed up exemption cards for people unable to wear a mask for health reasons. We were the only jurisdiction in Canada to do so. Everybody else who put in a mask bylaw, that was it. Well, anyway, they handed out these cards, no questions asked, to anybody who asked for one, including, I'm sure, quite a few people who launched protests at the legislature about face masks. They couldn't ask about health because the city has no authority to do so. But they figured, well, we can just take people at their word. Now, who's going to game the system? Who's going to cheat? Well, in just a couple of days, 6,000 of these things were in the hands of people who may or may not be eligible for them. Big public backlash from business, from ordinary citizens. The city has stopped handing out the cards, although they say the existing ones will be honored. I don't think anybody's going to turn them back in. In the meantime, I wish you all good health. Take care of others and take care of yourselves. Stay home, stay safe, and stay tuned to Eagle News for accurate and balanced coverage of the COVID-19 pandemic. In Edmonton, Canada, Thomas I. Likeness, Eagle News. We live in interesting times. Back to you, Anna.
Thank you for the updates in your part of the world, Thomas. You mentioned that frying an egg on the sidewalk. I have yet to try that. I've lived here in Vegas 20 years, and yes, you are correct. 112, high of 112 or 44 degrees Celsius here in Las Vegas today.
Oh, that's just brutal temperatures.
Yes. So even if there was no pandemic, these are the days when you just stay home. You either go out very, very, very early in the morning or when the sun goes down. But even then, it's still very hot outside.
Yeah, well, I was down there for NAB one time. They moved it to the fall. Actually, it was RTNDA. It was moved to the fall, and you know, you went outside and you just looked for the next air conditioned venue.
Yes, absolutely. That's our just be quick to be outside. That's the key here. But you have lots going on there, Thomas, with the extension of the closure of the border. How do most Canadians feel about that?
And how most Canadians are quite content to see it closed until further notice, mm-hmm. indefinitely. And the fear is, you know, we're bordering on Michigan, where there's a lot of cases there. We're bordering on Washington State, where there's been flare-ups again. And the fear is we've got enough problems of our own.
Yes.
We don't want to import. The coronavirus is a great hitchhiker.
Yes, absolutely. It doesn't stay in one place. And I'm surprised to hear about that, the card where people, it's like a pass not to wear a mask.
You got to wonder, don't these people think, you know, we're going to give these out on an honor system. And a week previous, there were hundreds of people protesting against masks. We'll hand these out, no questions asked.
Lots of trust in the government there. And you would think that with the flu season, like you mentioned, flu season around the corner, that would just be helpful also, not just for the coronavirus, but just for the flu.
Well, yeah, and that's going to hit both countries about the same time. Yes. So again, it's those basic public health measures.
Yes, and getting the flu shot.
Yeah. And no potlucks. I still miss potlucks, but they're still saying no more, you know, no buffets, no potlucks here.
Hopefully soon.
All right, Thomas.
Well, thank you so much for your updates.
Take care and stay cool.
You too. U.S.